Hi, Christine Keck in Los Angeles today at the 2011 OFC NFOEC event. And I'm here with ADVA's Michael Eiselt, who is Director of Advanced Technology. And Michael, you received yesterday an Optical Society of America Fellow Award. Congratulations on that.
Thank you very much, Christine. In fact, I'm grateful to all the great people and brilliant minds I worked with over my career and who developed me here. And also I want to thank all the people who put me forward to this fellowship award and who supported this award application.
You and I were both here at the event in 2010. Can you talk about what you've been doing over the past year since then?
Yeah, last year we talked about 100 gigabit per second. And in fact, this one has been commercialized now. You see products out in the field. And in the course of this project, we have done a field trial on 100 gigabit per second. And now we are moving forward to higher data rates. We're looking into 400 gigabit per second per channel, 1 terabit per second per channel. And we're also looking into how we can use the capacity that's available in the network more efficiently by using software-defined optics, as we call it, which is using the bandwidth efficiently, which is available on the optical fiber.
You're talking some really fast speeds now, terabit networking. Are these speeds necessary?
In fact, I mean, in the post-deadline session, we will see a fiber capacity of 100 terabit per second. And 15 years ago, we saw 1 terabit per second. So that's a growth of a factor of 100 in 15 years. You would think, wow, that's a lot. But then look at the required capacity, at the traffic that's out on the fiber network, and that grows by a factor of 10 in 8 years. So this research capacity is just there to support this required data capacity.
What else? I'm sure there's much. What else have you been working on?
Well, besides this high-capacity, high-speed topics, we're working on optical access schemes, namely WDM-PON. Mm-hmm. So there we will send a fiber to the end user, to the houses, and each fiber will contain a capacity of 1 gigabit per second. So everybody will be able to get a data stream of 1 gigabit per second in their house. And we're working with component suppliers because in order to make this effective and cost-effective, we need to get very low-cost components. Only then this 1 gigabit per second will be taken up by the people or by the users, and then we can support a mass rollout. So that's basically what we're working on now, this fiber access networks.
You mentioned low cost. That's a buzzword I'm sure the component vendors hate to hear, but it's something that a lot of people talk about. It makes things affordable and it makes them more able to be used in the networks. What else have you been hearing at the conference this year?
Well, we're talking about high capacity, and the fiber capacity is somewhere limited, and so people are working now at new fibers, for instance, multi-core fibers, where you do not have only one single core in a fiber to transport this 100 terabit capacity, but multiple cores, so you can multiply the capacity of your single fiber. Now, on the other side, on the component side, I'm seeing a lot of talk about silicon photonics, because in order to make these high data rates cost and also energy efficient, you need to integrate all these devices, and then we will be able to proceed to these very high capacities.
Optics continues to be fascinating and doesn't ever slow down. Again, congratulations on your award and for all your contributions, and we look forward to hearing more from you next year about all the things that ADVA will continue to work on.
Thank you, Christine.
Thank you. If you want more information about ADVA Optical Networking, you can find us on the web at www.advaoptical.com. Thank you.